ओके टुडे आई हैव टू स्टार्ट द रोटेशनल मैकेनिकल सिस्टम ट्रांसफर फंक्शंस व्हिच इज 2.6 प्रीवियसली वी हैव कंप्लीटेड 2.5 टॉपिक 2.5 सो लेट मी एक्सप्लेन फ्यू थिंग्स फ्रॉम हियर फ्रॉम द 2.0 ओके आई विल कम बैक टू this topic later. The rotational transfer function, see, the rotational system, here, see this, having covered electrical and transmission mechanical system, we now move on to consider rotational mechanical systems. Rotational mechanical systems are handled the same way as translational mechanical systems, except that the torque replaces force and angular displacement replaces translational displacement. Angular displacement, rotational system, any rotational system covering this thing. The mechanical components for rotational systems are the same as those for translational systems, except that the components undergo rotation instead of translation. Table 2.5 shows the components along with the relationship between the torque and angular velocity as well as the angular displacement. Okay, now see. See this. Torque and angular velocity, torque and angular displacement, and impedance. See this thing here, the one thing added, which is the angle and torque added, torque t, theta t angle, and the displacement constant k, spring constant k, viscous damper ds, inertia j. Okay, these things. T newton meters, theta t radian, omega t radian per second, k newton meter per radian, d newton meter second per radian, j kg meter square per radian. See, these are the things. Okay, we'll see this later when we do the maths. Okay, one by one. Okay, see here. This component, K, D, and J, spring constant, coefficient of viscous friction, and moment of inertia. J is the moment of inertia. The impedances of mechanical components are also summarized in the last column. The values, okay. Okay, you'll see this later one by one. I need to do the math. Now see this problem, 2.19. Find the transfer function theta 2s by ts for the rotational system shown in figure 2.22a. Okay, find the transfer function theta 2s by ts for the rotational system. Okay, see this. Find the transfer function for the rotational system showing figure. The rod is supported. This is the rod, okay. The rod is supported by bearings. These are the bearing at either end and is undergoing torsion. And it has a torsion. A torque is applied at the left here. And the displacement is measured at the right. Displacement measured at the line, right? So if you apply the torque, like if you want to move it, then this portion will have some effect for this portion, for the torque. Okay, now see, first obtain the schematic from the physical diagram, a physical system, even though torsion occurs throughout the rod in figure 2.2a. We approximate the system by assuming that the torsion acts like a spring concentrated at one particular point in the rod with an inertia J1 to the left and an inertia J2 at the right. Okay. Two inertia they will felt. One is J1 and another one is J2. We also assume that the damping inside the flexible shaft is negligible. The schematic is shown in figure 2.22b. That is the schematic. There are 2 degrees of freedom. Since each inertia can be rotated while the other is held still, hence it will take 2 simultaneous equations to solve the system. So we need the 2 simultaneous equations to solve this system, like the previous translational mechanical system. Okay. Draw a free body diagram of J1. J1, free body diagram of J1, and the free body diagram of J2. Two things. Okay, free body diagram of J1 and free body diagram of J2. Okay. See this J1. Torque is applying here. Torque is applying here. And this thing, like the K, D1, J1, these are affecting against the torque. These are working against the torque. Like if you want to rotate anything, then something will occur, okay, which will try to block your rotation. Okay, that is the thing, and that is the theta 1 is direction. Theta 1 is direction. See, torque on J1 due only to the motion of J1. Torque of J1 are due to only to the motion of J2. And final free body, this is the final diagram. Okay, like the previous one. And similarly, you can do the same thing for the J2. And then make the equations. And from the equation, Rigor transfer function is theta 2 by Ts. So when we let me show you from this equation how to find the theta 2. Let's say I want to found the theta 2. So if I want to find the theta 2, then what I have to do, write this one J1 s square plus T1 s plus K Ts. Okay, here zero, definitely zero, because there is no term, and here is the zero, not zero, sorry, it will not be zero. Where is the rubber eraser? Now, okay, theta 2 or no, or we can do like another way, okay, by delta. Now what will happen? See that just multiply it, then only T will be there. So minus T. So it is minus. Okay, the theta 2 term will not affect here. Only this term will affect. Okay. So it would be Ts. Just a minute, anything wrong here? This is theta 2. If you consider this thing, it will be 0, and this thing Ts will be there. Ts will be there. here is the K. They missed it. K is there. Okay, K is there. K is there. So they missed it. K is there. So it would be delta theta 2, then theta 2 by ts is equal to k by delta. Okay, like this. Okay. So here is the k. So they missed it. Because, let me show you. K is there. Okay, see K is there. So you have to consider the K. So at first theta 1, K theta 1. K theta 1, see K theta 1 is there. So equation would be K theta 1. K theta 1. So just use this one. Okay. Minus K theta. Like this, like the previous one. And see, you can do this on the MATLAB also. Okay, you can do this in the MATLAB also. If I can complete this one, then I can show this. Similar thing happen like this only. Write but do not solve. See this one, 3-1, J1, J2, J3. So you will have the three equations. Okay, you will have the three equations, D1, D2, D3. So for the J1, see, at first, sum of the impedances connected to the motion at theta 1. So which impedances are connected? D1, T1, okay, those are connected. Minus some impedances between theta 1 and theta 2, some between theta 1 and theta 3. A similar thing happened. So at first one, say, let's explain this one. J1, D1, and K. See, for the first equation, J1, D1, and K, these three will be positive. And minus KJ2 would be negative. Minus K theta 2 would be negative. And this is zero, definitely zero, because there is no connection between the J3. Okay. And for the second one, the theta 1 term will be negative. Theta 1 term, that means K theta 1, and plus positive thing would be the theta 2 term, J2S square, D2S plus K. J2S square, D2S plus K. This thing would be positive, and this thing will be negative. D2S theta 3, for the theta 3. Okay, and the third one, theta 1 is 0, theta 2 term, J2 term would be negative, and J3 term would be positive. Okay, like this. Okay, like this, you can just draw the equation of the this thing, this rotational system. This is another one. And
if 2.127.
27?
2.127A.
Wait, 2.27. Which one? 2.27.
130.
1.27. 27. 2.25. See, 2.20, right?
Yeah.
This. Okay.
No, sir. 19.
19. Okay. Yeah. Okay. This one?
Yes, sir. A waves from meniscus theta 2.
Okay, let me explain it again. Full math again. Okay, again I am explaining this. See. Okay, try to understand this time. So the question is find the theta 2 by Ts. So theta 2 is the here. Yeah. T is here. So T is the input. Theta 2 is the output. So it is the basic thing. It is a rod. It is a rod and connected with the bearing. A rod connected with the bearing. And the bearing replacing the D1, D2. And J is the moment of inertia. T is the torque. Theta is the angle. Okay. Now since if I apply the torque here, then it will try to move. Okay. From the torque means you are trying to rotate this thing, rotate the rod. Then in between this portion and this portion, there will be spring. A spring type thing will happen. Okay, in between them. In between them, a spring type thing will happen. Okay. And this is the and see, so from this one, from this figure, I can write this, I can draw this kind of figure. Just taking the note that J1 is one part and J2 is another part. And here in between the spring. So that I can easily calculate the thing, calculate the equations. Okay, I can easily find out the transfer function. Okay, so now consider this one, this J1. Now see. Let me see here. Let me show you here that for the J1, see how many things are connected. So these things are for J1 and this here J2 is connected for the through the spring, through the spring. So minus K theta 2 will be there, right? K theta 2 will be there. And theta 2s, okay, theta 2s is equal to Ts. And what will be the positive thing? What will be the positive thing here? Positive thing would be like this. The D1 is connected, theta 1 is connected, J is connected. So the J1 S square plus D1 S plus K theta 1 plus K theta 1 S. See how I write this? So I just check. J1 itself has a moment of inertia, right? J1. See, that's why it is J1 S square D1. This is connected with the bearing. So that's why it comes. And K, this portion has a spring. So K is there. And T is the overall thing. And common thing with the J1 is, J2 is what? A spring. This is common. This part is common, so it will be negative. So it is the equation of the first part. And similarly, if you look at the second portion, so minus K theta 1. Minus K theta 1 is why minus? Because the common with the J1 is the K. And here, the theta 1 comes. For the J, theta 1, for the J2, theta 2. Now, for the J2, first of all, J2 S square, because it has the moment of inertia plus D2S plus D2S plus K and theta 2S. Here is equal to 0. Why 0? See, there is no torque in this portion, no torque, right? No force. no torque. Is it correct torque? Okay. Okay. That's why we write these two equations. Now, sorry. Okay, now you can find out the here from here you can find out the T and theta 2 equation. Let's find out the theta 2. Theta 2 is equal to what? Theta 2 is equal to, when we consider the theta 2, so J1 S square plus D1S plus K, and here the TS minus K theta 1 minus K, and here the 0 and the delta is here. And finally, what we can write? We can write that, see, this will be 0, cross multiplication, this will be 0. And here be positive K minus KTS. Minus KTS delta. So I can write that KTS by delta. So finally, I can write that theta 2 divided by TS, or theta 2s actually, theta 2s is equal to K by delta. See, that's how they solve it. Okay, these two equations. Okay, you do not need to write all things. Okay. You do not need to write all things. Try to understand. Okay, that's how we solve this kind of problem. Okay. Now let's move on to the next one. Let me clear this thing. So you do not draw these things. Okay, just look at the figure and write the equations directly. You no need to write all things. That is the rotational system. Now if I look at here, so now see that this problem 2.20, if I look at here, at first J1 for this, see, the question is write but do not solve the Laplace transform of the equal motion. Okay, equation of motion. So I have to write the Laplace transform here. Okay, so what I have to do for the first one, see, the equation would be, let's say, J1 S square plus D1 S plus K theta 1 minus K theta 2 minus 0 0 theta 3 is equal to t. Yes, that is the first equation. And the second equation would be minus k theta 1 plus j 2 s square plus d 2 s plus k theta 2 minus here d 2 s d 2 s theta 3 is equal to 0. And the third equation would be for this one. For this one, third equation would be like this. Minus 0 theta 1 minus the second one. Second one has the d2. D2 is theta 2 plus the third one. J 3 s square plus the d 2 s plus d 3 s theta 3 s is equal to 0. Here see, there is no spring, so there is no k. Check this thing. This is the thing. So only this up to this, so we do not need to solve this thing, solve these equations. Rather, we just write the equation. Okay. See, same thing what I have written so far. These three equations, only these three equations. So your job is to write the equations. In the exam, you no need to write these things. No need. Okay, just on the equation. Okay, and if you add the gear, if you add the gear system, if you add the gear system, you see, two kind of gears are there. A gear system. T1 theta 1 input gear, input drive gear, and this is the output drive. If you rotate this gear, then this gear will rotate. Okay, and gear system, see this. Let me we are able to find the transfer function for rotational systems. So we realize that these systems, especially those driven by motors, are rarely seen without associated gear trains driving the load. This section covers this important topic, gear. See, gear provide mechanical advantage to rotational system. I think you are familiar with the gear. When you drive the bicycle, okay, then I think you are familiar with the gear. Okay, anyone who has ridden 10 speed bicycle knows the effect of gearing. Going uphill, you shift to provide more torque and less speed. On the straightaway, you shift to obtain more speed and less torque. Thus, gears allow you to match the drive system and that load, a trade-off between speed and torque. See, so when you are familiar with the bicycle, then you will understand this thing. For many applications, gears exhibit backlash, which occurs because of the loose fit between two meshed gears. The driven gear rotates through a small angle before making contact with the meshed gears. Okay. So here, just look at the figure. An input gear with radius R1, input gear which is the radius R1 and N1 teeth is rotated through angle theta 1 due to a torque T1. An output gear with radius R2, output gear has the radius R2 and the N2 teeth responds by rotating through the angle theta 2. Okay. And delivering a torque T2. Let us now find the relationship between the rotating gear, rotation of gear 1, theta 1 and theta 2. So it is the equation R1 theta 1 is equal to R2 theta 2. So R1 by R2 is equal to theta 2 by theta 1. So R1 theta 2 by theta 1 is equal to R1 by R2 is equal to N1 by N2. It is the first equation. Theta 2 by theta 1 is equal to R1 by R2 is equal to N1 by N2. And for the torque, T1 theta 1 is equal to T2 theta 2. So T2 by T1 is equal to theta 1 by theta 2 or N2 by N1. So some equations are also there. So if I consider the theta 1 is the input and the theta 2 is the output, then I have to write that N2 by N1. N1 by N2 or the T2 by T1. See, theta 2 by theta 1 is equal to theta 2 by theta 1 is equal to N1 by N2. And T2 by T1 is equal to N2 by N1. See, transfer function for angular displacement in lossless gears and the torque in lossless gears. See two things. Transfer functions for angular displacement in lossless gears and torque in lossless gears. Okay. Two things are there. And similar kind of thing, the rotational system driven by gears. If you have the gear, then this thing will work. This thing will be added. Okay, here the torque, T1, theta 1, theta 2. And rotational system driven by gears, equivalent system at the output after reflection of input torque. Equivalent system at the input after reflection of impedances. Okay, these are the things. Okay. These are the things. So, see here T1 theta 1 and N1 N2, this is the ratio of the teeth, theta 2. For the theta 1, for the torque 1, theta 2 will happen. And equivalent system, this is the equivalent system. So, T1. Into N2 by N1, N2 by N1. So T1 into N2 by N1. And the equivalent system and the input after reflection of the impedance. So after the impedance, after the reflection, it would be D into N1 by N2 square, K into N1 by N2 square. Okay. So finally, some equations developed like this. So this is the first equation, this is the second equation, this is the third equation. After simplification, this kind of equation will happen, will occur. So finally, they generalized the following statement: rotational mechanical impedances can be reflected through gear trains by multiplying the mechanical impedances by the ratio. Number of teeth of the gear on the demonstration shaft divided by number of teeth of the gear in the source shaft. So that is N2 by N1 whole square. Okay, now let's look at the example transfer function system with lossless gears. Find the transfer function theta 2 by T1s for the system shown below. Okay. Yeah, rotational mechanical system with gears, system after reflection of the torque and if the impedances to the shaft. Okay. it is the initial diagram. So what would be the final diagram? See this. T1 N2, see here, when you apply the T1, this is the equivalent. J1 and J2, just we write the, you draw the equivalent one, equivalent torque. This two, N2 by N1 into theta 2, it will happen. And D2, that means the 2D, 2D1 and D2. So what is would be the equivalent? D1 into N2 by N1 whole square, D1 N2 by N1 whole square plus D2 plus D2. And K equivalent 1K, so it is K equal to K2. So what would be J? J1 into N2 by N1 whole square plus J2. That is the equivalent. Now you have to see the equations. So for the equations, what would happen? Say for the JES² plus DES plus KE into T1S, into T1S. Okay, see here, JES² plus DES into theta 2S is equal to T1 into N2 by N1. Where J is the, this one, D is this one, K is this one. So now for the theta 2, the transfer function found to be, so what would be the transfer function theta 2 by T1S? So it will come here. So N2 by N1 will come here. See, it is easier. This one is easier than the previous one. Only one equation is there. Not the multiple equations, only one equation will be there. Okay. So if you have the multiple teeth, then this kind of equations will be there. Gears with loss. So if we consider the find the transfer function theta 1 by T1 is for the system of figure 2.32. System using a gear train. So this is the gear train equivalent system. So what would be the equivalent system? These are the gear train, okay, up to J4. So equivalent T1 theta 1 DE, KJ J1 plus J2 plus J3, this one plus J4 plus J5, this one up to this. Okay, just take a look at these problems. Okay, I'm not very much interested about this. Now this is important, the electromechanical system. After finishing this one, this chapter will be finished. Okay, so I want to finish it today, because in the next class I want to start the new chapter 3 and 4. Okay, chapter 3 and 4. So electromechanical system is important. Like, see, a DC motor, a simple example is the DC motor. See the schematic diagram. Armature equivalent, armature voltage, armature resistance, armature inductance. This is the armature circuit. Okay, this is the fixed load rotor. See figure 2.35a. A magnetic field is developed by stationary permanent magnets or a stationary electromagnet called the fixed field. If you apply the fixed field, then a magnetic field will be developed. A rotating circuit called the armature, through which current IAT flows, passes through this magnetic field at right angles and fields a force F. Okay, where B is the, so see, passes through this magnetic field at right angles and fields a force F equal to BL IAT. Where B is the magnetic field strength and L is the length of the conductor. B is the magnetic field, L is the length of the conductor. L is the length of the conductor, B is the magnetic field. Okay, there is another phenomena that occur in the motor. A conductor moving at right angles to a magnetic field generates a voltage at the terminals of the conductor equal to E VLV, where E is the voltage and V is the velocity of the conductor normal to the magnetic field. Since the current carrying armature is rotating in a magnetic field, its voltage is proportional to speed. Thus, V B K B d theta m t d t, and then after that they replace the d theta m dt with the wmt is the angular velocity of motor, replaced by this one. Again they change the relationship between the armature current iat and applied armature voltage eat. Iat and eat and the back emf vvt is formed by writing a loop equation around the Laplace transform armature circuit. See figure 3.5a. where is the figure 3.5a? Okay, I don't know. Just a minute. What is the figure 3.5A? Okay, just they use the equations here, final equations. They finally found few things like, let me show these equations. Okay. Theta m by ES. Theta m by ES, this equation you have to develop up to this. For the, if I want to show you that, just one by one, okay, one by one, and the loop equation RA into IA, LA into IA, okay, VB, RA IA, LA into LS IA plus VB is equal to ES, okay. Yes, and then the torque developed by the motor is proportional to the armature current. So torque is proportional to the armature current, where Tm is the torque developed by the motor. Kt is the constant of proportionality called the motor torque constant. So Ia is, so here find out the Ia. Now to find the transfer function of the motor, refers to substitute equation 2.145 and 2.148 into 146. This one and this one into this one, 2.146. So instead of VB, I write this one equation. This equation instead of IA, I write this equation. So after writing this equation, they found this. Now, TM in terms of theta M. So they have to find the TM in terms of theta M. Typical equivalent mechanical leading on a motor. This is the motor mechanical system. Okay, so theta m by ems. So tm is what here, jms square plus dms into theta m. So instead of tm, write this one, and now do calculation, then they will find finally this kind of equations. Okay, just one by one. Since I do not have the whiteboard, so I cannot show you all things by writing on the board. Okay, so but if I write on the board, then it would be more interesting. Okay, so that is the our drawback here. Okay, so you have to see up to this 2.153. remember, 2.153. So if I give it to it to you, it as an assignment. So what you will do, you will draw this circuit diagram. Okay, you will draw this circuit diagram and this block diagram. Draw the circuit diagram and the block diagram, and starting from this one. Okay, VB. This one, VB is equal to KB d theta m dt. And actually not here, few lines you have to write for me, like this equation and the associated values of these equations also here. Okay, I'll just write these equations, not all. Okay, up to this 2.153. So starting from the 2.144, you will finish at the 2.153. This is the equation for the DC motor. Electromechanical system. This is a electromechanical system transfer function. Electromechanical system transfer function. So if I ask you to develop a transfer function of an electromechanical system, then you can easily develop it by the DC motor system. Okay. Here they reduce it. Put this one as the alpha. Okay. Let's say again they explain few more things. Okay. So I am stopping here. Just you can skip this thing. But if you have interest, just you can look this kind of problems. Okay, so this is our ending of the chapter 2. Okay, chapter 2. Just this thing. And if you want, you can look at the example 2.23. Okay, or I'll show you it later if possible. Now tell me guys, just what you have understand so far. Nine persons are there. I'm just stopping the sharing as well as